Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Robin Hood board member, John Sykes.
Good evening. On behalf of the Robin Hood board and David Saltzman, our executive director of Robin Hood, thank you so much for coming and welcome to the Beacon. You know, I think we are among the 2,600 luckiest people on the planet tonight. Because we are going to witness history. One of the true great bands in the world is going to play one of the most amazing old venues in America days before it closes down for renovations. It's also a historical event because tonight is the single most successful night financially in the 76-year history of the Beacon Theater. Tonight, thanks to your generosity, we have raised $3 million to fight poverty in New York City. And because the Robin Hood Board picks up all the expenses, every dollar you gave tonight will go to fighting poverty. Now, I'd like to thank, if you're one of our regular Robin Hood supporters, thank you so much for your continued support. If you're a new friend who came to see our special guest tonight, then thank you, and we hope you become a regular. We need you at Robin Hood, and your neighbors who are poor and homeless in New York need you also. I'd like to give special thanks to our own, Robin Hood's own, Lori Fabiano, who executive produces Holy Week. And to the best live producer and production team I've ever worked with from Live Nation, Dan Parisi and his team. And to our friends at Madison Square Garden and the Beacon Theater who have been so helpful. But finally, and most importantly, thank you to our special guest. Because when we called them up a year ago to ask them to do this, they said yes immediately, and they did it free of charge. And they are true friends of New York City and of Robin Hood. And I'd like to thank, from their management, their manager, my longtime friend Kelly Curtis, Dick Smith, my long-term friend, and Mark Smith. Now, they just spent the summer playing a sold-out tour of much bigger buildings than this, including Madison Square Garden last week. But tonight, we have them to ourselves at the Beacon. So they're going home tomorrow, so you need to give a loud and warm welcome, Robin, welcome to Pearl Jam.
Oh, We're just going to ease into this thing. You know, something John just said is it had a lot of resonance to hear, is that he said that we were friends of New York, and that's an honor. If we can feel like we're friends with New York, because New York has done so much for this band, so it's a pleasure to do something to give back in our way. Thank you.
Yeah.
So this is the last night of our tour. We've been on up through the East. And I think we're all just making it over the finish line. Me in particular, I actually had to get a shot right there. A steroid shot to help my throat tonight. I don't know if it's making a difference, but this is going to make a difference. Here are three great singers from New York, who I think we consider them honorary members of our band. At this point, this is Fonzie Thornton, Venice Thomas, and Arif St. Michael, right? And it's only because of them that we were able to theorize that this could be part of the set tonight, so we're gonna give it a shot.
Thank you. You play with our world like it was surely a toy. enlist our friends now? It's a song we never played until just a couple weeks ago. Well, I guess when we were at the Garden with these folks and maybe Bonnaroo or something, but it's called All Night.
Thank you.
See, this song was written about a homeless guy that I met. His name was Eddie, in Seattle when I first moved there in 1989 or 1990. There's also a guy in San Diego that I knew called Ben, but it's kind of an amalgamation of the two. So I got to have more reason than usual. Play it tonight.
Yeah.
We'd like to do this one because we have our backup help here. This one, so it's called Mark. That we're taking a hell of a lot of money from you, so we're gonna stick around for as long as we can. Right? I should clarify, we're not taking the money. It's, you know, the whole concept of Robin Hood, it goes back to when we were kids, and it always made an impact, the concept alone, when I was a kid. You know, stealing from the rich and giving to the poor. It's always been a very good concept, and, you know, living in the United States, especially the last 6 years, we've seen that concept like never before. The problem is they've cleverly and diabolically changed the concept to where they are stealing for the poor and giving to the rich in the form of the form of this avoidable war that is now. We raised an incredible amount of money tonight. Usually we do something like this, we raise maybe $1 million, which is huge. $3 million I'm told tonight, and we thank you for that. And it's nice to have an opportunity to be advocates for a voiceless segment of our society, and also to be in this position to feel and accept your generosity. So thank you once again for making this all real. This is a song that, it's called Undone. Not too many people heard it. The important line is this one that says, "Can't wait for election day."
Glasses change.
Pearl Jam. Again, Fonzie Thornton. Born in Memphis, Tennessee, Venice Thomas. I don't know where he was born, but I'm glad he was. The Reef St. Michael.
I'm not the same.
That's a Boom Gaspar on the B3. Stone Gossard right there. Museums, basketball courts, skate parks. I love him when he's right next to the bass amp. That's Jeff Ament. This song's written by a woman who we've known for many, many years, and she's one of the best. It's her name's Victoria Williams.
Side of the town on the wrong side of the tracks. Sometimes on the way into town, I say, Mother, can we stop and get a ride? Sometimes we hear her hands move from her side. Thank you.
Hey, cheers, everybody in the back. That's really only about 25th row in a normal game. Everybody in the middle. Make it better. I wouldn't change any of this right here. This is just... This is where probably a year ago they filmed the Rolling Stones here. Scorsese did that too. And I was... See, the one thing they could change is not this room, but the dressing rooms are pretty... 1920s, but I was picturing Mick Jagger in one of those dressing rooms. But and then I thought of all the pink scarves that were covering all the peeling paint, and I'm sure it was fun. I'm gonna do something now because it's intimate enough. I'll tell you a quick story here. We were in West Virginia, I think, and at the end of the show, I was kind of prancing around a bit or something, and somebody reached up and put an envelope in my hand. And I put it in my pocket, which was drenched. And 2 days later, I unrolled it, and the ink was bleeding and the whole thing. But I could see this picture of four children with guitars. Just gorgeous, handsome kids. Oldest boy, who I believe is 12, 13. And then 11, 8, and 6, these three little girls. Now, their dad was a guy called John McDonough. He had been to, he was a Marine who had served in Iraq, I believe. He worked with the Pentagon. Him and his wife Ruth, and apparently he was heading back at some point. He'll be back, I think, in Afghanistan next time, maybe within the year. But they just put a simple request: we play music. The kids love your group; they're very inspired. And if we could just get 2 minutes of your time, we'd love to say hello. So we took this tattered, ripped-up piece of paper, and we called them when we got to D.C. And I got to meet these great kids and their parents and the dad. And, they were lovely, and they brought us a few little gifts, all of which we treasure. And but the one thing that they gave was a small CD, and they said, you know, we wrote a song. We were inspired to kind of write a song, and I think it was the 11-year-old girl. Let's see, their names are Joey's the oldest boy, then McKellen, Maddie. I think Murphy is 6. So I'm gonna play this song. It's a minute and a half long, and it's. This is all them. It wasn't meant for broadcast. It was just meant for our ears. But I called them and asked if we could, if we could play it. And they're very happy. It was of all the things that we've offered to other people, to get this kind of thing back was a huge gift. And I just thought I'd share this gift with you. So, Nelly, they're calling themselves 3MJ, because there's three Maddies and one Joey. 3MJ, and I think the song is called Make a Difference. So here we go.
We can plant some seeds and grow.
I'm going to sing this one for John, Ruth, and the kids, and then my friend Thomas Young. I don't know if you've heard of Thomas. He's a Iraqi veteran that came back with some critical injuries in a wheelchair and paralyzed from about the chest down. And recently he went through another battle where he's been in critical condition again and not doing so well. The other thing, you know, we're talking about homeless and poverty-stricken, and you hear that half the babies born in New York every day are born into poverty. And that this organization raises maybe $138 million a year. And that's just a drop in the bucket. And meanwhile, $3 billion a week are going to this deal, and we gotta stop the bleeding. Being pro-military and against the war, those are not mutually exclusive ideals. So this is for Thomas.
Oh,
Peter, thanks for listening and thanks for singing.
I got to be good to talk.
big donors, a lot of donors.
We'll be right back.
Thanks for everything you've given us. Thanks for letting us give back. Love you. Good night. Goodbye. Be well. Peace. New president next time we come. New president. Love you.